hours getting set for the weekend, which means we are getting set for football. And without further ado, it is time for Pigskin Preview. Tony Anzetti, Larry Kotler in the studio with us as we get all primed and ready. Gentlemen, y'all ready for tonight?
Yeah, it's going to feel ready. Yeah. I mean, by the end of the night, we might see some frost on the ground. Yeah. This is football weather.
This is
for real.
Football weather, isn't it, Tony?
Yes. And now we're rolling into week 8 and 9 of the Iowa high school football season. So now if you haven't made the playoffs, you're working to get there. And if you're in the playoffs, you're working for that playoff position by winning a game in your district to try to maybe get make sure you get the number one seed or at least be the 3 or 4. So a lot of positioning going on tonight, and there's a bunch of really interesting games in Central Iowa, including the one over at Waukee, which I will be at for the Central Iowa Sports Network tonight. I'll be working with Dar Danielson doing that game for CISN-TV, and that's a top 10 battle.
Tell Dar hello.
I will. Number 7 Waukee and number 7 Fort Dodge and number 8 Waukee, according to the polls I put out each and every week. So Fort Dodge, remember before the season started, I said they would be my sleeper team to watch out for them. That by the time they got to week 8, they could be 7-0. Well, they've done that part and they made me look good. But their schedule, not that great. The teams they played have a combined record of 12-37. When you look at Waukee, the combined schedule of their teams are 31-17. They are 5-2, but they've played some very good competition. So tonight, it's Fort Dodge's chance to say, to show me, how good they really are.
Sounds to me like the Fort Dodge people have better schedulers.
Well, they played some of the weaker sisters, unfortunately. But they do have some really good kids. One kid, Sam Cook, is probably, no doubt to me, a Division I player. And maybe he'll stay here in the state of Iowa, but he'll be somebody you'll be seeing down the road. He's an outstanding tailback, almost 1,500 yards and 21 touchdowns on the season. So
already.
Johnny Bice at quarterback and his top receiver, Sam Colasia, they're going to be, big targets. They're the big three. They're legitimate. And they've done what they're supposed to do against bad teams. They've not just beat them, they've beat them soundly. So tonight, Waukee's a big test, and it's at Waukee. And Ben Furkin, outstanding quarterback there. He's thrown for over 1,500 yards and 11 touchdowns. And they've got a very good balanced team. So Fort Dodge's defense may be tested tonight for one of the few times. I know the biggest game they had was Indianola, and they gave up a little bit of points against Indianola, outscored them though, but they've been averaging nearly 50 points a game. That's not going to probably happen tonight. They'd love to see them get that because that means they have a shot. They want more of that up-tempo game probably and get that score up. If it stays down, then it's got to favor Waukee tonight because I got to think that the Warriors defense, who only lost to Dowling Catholic and West Des Moines Valley in the Dowling Catholic game, was down to the wire 28-21, and all Dowling is still number one in defending state champs. So Waukee's been tested. It's going to be a great game tonight over there at Waukee tonight. We'll see what happens. So another couple games, Ankeny Centennial at West Des Moines Valley. Centennial's going to have to really step it up to get back into the rankings and make something happen. This would be a big one for them. Also in Class 2A, Prairie City Monroe is at number one Albia, and boy, the Blue Devils have just been playing great football over there in Albia. Prairie City Monroe, kind of a little bit of a surprise, playing very well. Now we'll see where they really stand. And Pleasantville down in Class A, they're ranked number 4. They're taking on Mount Air. That'll be for the district championship there. So big game down in Pleasantville tonight for some of the area schools in Central Iowa. A bunch of top 10 matchups across the state. So, when you look statewide, and one of them, Cedar Rapids Xavier, number 2 in 3A, takes on top-ranked and number 1 Iowa City Regina.
That's a rivalry, too.
Yeah, and that was a team that snapped Iowa City Regina's winning streak last year. So the Regina doesn't back down from any. So a great Catholic matchup over there in that one. Harlan at number 6 taking on a surprise team this year, an undefeated Glenwood at number 10. So that's a big matchup in their district. And number 7, Independence, a team you don't hear a lot about. They take on third-rated West Delaware. So 3A's got some really good top 10 matchups going on. So some great high school football tonight across the state, and looking forward to it. And, of course, you can check out Central Iowa Sports Network, CISN.TV, for our coverage, both audio and video games tonight. And of course, I'll be at Waukee with Dar Danielson for that Waukee Fort Dodge game.
Now, you audio or video tonight?
We're both video and audio.
Oh, tonight. Excellent. Yeah, beautiful. All right, may have to tune in.
Yes,
check you out.
Okay.
All right. Mr. Cotman, what's going on collegiately?
Well, got some very interesting games. We're going to start with Evanston, Illinois.
where number 17 Iowa takes on number 20 Northwestern. Now, a lot of people are going to look at what happened with Northwestern last week, and they go, ah, see, I told you where they weren't that good, because they got hammered by Michigan 38-0. Mm-hmm. But the more I researched this game yesterday, the more I got scared.
Why?
Well, they have a freshman quarterback who's up and down and up and down. Clayton Thorson is his name. Against Duke, he threw for 38% completion. 48 against Michigan, 39 against Duke. They have a good running game. They were a good defensive team. And Iowa's a little banged up now, especially on the offensive line. Yeah, they really are. So I'm a little nervous about this game. I think it's going to be a defensive game. There'll be a lot of running. There won't be a lot of offense in this particular game. But you know what this game's going to come down to? As with every Iowa Northwestern game, turnovers. Yeah. Turnovers, 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 turnovers. And that was every time they play. I'm really nervous about this game. I'm actually going to pick the upset this time. Yeah. I think Northwestern's going to pull the upset by maybe a late field goal, something like that. I hope I'm wrong.
A lot of people are picking that. Mm-hmm. Both with the injuries, that Northwestern seems to have Iowa's number. Yeah. Speaking of numbers, 45 degrees for kickoff, so it's going to be a chilly one. Keep that in mind if you're headed over to Evanston.
A lot of people are, too. A lot of Iowa fans end up showing up in Evanston.
Right. Well, and it's a team that's 6-0. I mean, this team is playing very good football, but I guess I'm just nervous about the Northwestern thing. They know how to play against Iowa, so I hope I'm wrong.
And they hate us. I didn't realize the extent to which Northwestern hated Iowa.
No, I didn't realize they hated them.
They really do.
They're not fans.
You know about the fans?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Oh, I don't even know the players.
Last year. Way back to
Iowa rolled last year against that team. So.
Right, they did. But I don't know. This one scares me. Now, and if this one scares you, where do you see the one in Ames?
Okay, next.
So I hate to say that because, you know, Iowa State, you know, last week they gave up 776 yards of offense. They lost, what, 66?
Say that number again because I don't think people caught that last
776.
Wow.
That's
just
a
like
lot of
running
numbers.
Up and down the field with no one on it almost.
Pretty much. That was not good.
I heard Rhodes was trying helmets on this week.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, okay.
66-31 last week, if I remember correctly. And they got TCU coming to town. Now, TCU escaped. I was telling Tony, my brother lives in Manhattan, Kansas. They went to the game last week where K-State was up 18, and Trevon Boykin had a couple late plays, as he always seems to do. Mm-hmm. That's the second time this year they've escaped. They got the one against Texas Tech, 55-52, in that great defensive league we know as the Big 12. And, you know, but the problem is TCU's going to throw the ball, throw the ball, throw the ball, throw the ball, and Iowa State's going to have a tough time defending that. And they've got to get better performance out of their quarterback, Sam Richardson, the quarterback, Sam Richardson, not the defensive back.
Right.
But, you know, the kid is running, the one kid who's running so well for Iowa State, Mike Warren, 245 yards last week, and TCU does give up yards on the ground.
But just keep handing the ball to him.
Well, I think that's what they'll do. They'll have a steady diet of Mike Warren. And we saw the temperature situation there about, what, 50?
Of
course, it's a night game. Now it's a night game.
It's going to get chilly as the game goes on.
Yeah. So that one may not be pretty.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping, you know, Paul Rhodes has sprung a few upsets over the years. This would be a big one.
This would be a good time to do another one.
It wouldn't hurt. It couldn't hoit, as they say.
And,
you know, a couple of other games. Drake is at San Diego. Drake had a big win last week over Valpo for homecoming. They're right in the thick of the things in the PFL. Northern Iowa's at home for homecoming, and they've got Western Illinois coming into town. Western Illinois won some games. They're undefeated in conference. But you know what? Northern Iowa's at home.
Well,
that's homecoming.
Them,
They're not losing at home to Leathernecks.
No.
That's not going to happen. But and they played tough with North Dakota State. They were up 14-3. And then they lost 31-28 in the last minute of the game.
Wow.
But that's twice in a row they've lost. Now they beat North Dakota State last year at home. But 2 years ago, they lost one in overtime to North Dakota State. So they're always that close to ND State, but they can't beat them on the road.
Thorn
in their side.
Right, but they got Western Illinois. And then Grandview is on the road. They're going down to Lamoni and play Graceland.
Oh, really? Okay.
And you know we're picking Woodley's team. We always put Woodley's team.
It doesn't matter who. They'd be playing the Bears, and Cotler would pick Woodley's team, right?
Probably.
Yeah,
probably
at least now they will. Yeah.
Yep.
Wonderful. We all caught up?
Yep,
that's good.
We are all caught up.
All right, and don't forget, Cop Man is back on radio every week on Thursday nights. Tell everybody where.
1350 ESPN. We had Fergie Jenkins on
that
last night.
That was awesome having Fergie on.
Yeah, he
Chicago
was cool.
Cub. He must have been pumped about the Cubs.
He was, but he was pretty low key about the whole thing. He's still in the organization, but I mean, he's pretty excited about it.
I remember going to a Cubs game one time when Fergie, because I grew up in the era when Fergie Jenkins and Billy Williams and Ron Santo and Don Kessinger, all those guys, Randy Huntley, that was the team, and he was pitching. and hits a home run to win the game. Fergie Jenkins, I'm talking about.
Yeah, he had great battles with Bob Gibson. So, I mean, it was fun talking to him. Brad Banks was on yesterday, John Torchetti, the coach of the Wild. And we had our good mutual buddy, Willie Farrell. Because they have a big benefit coming up at the Funny Bone. I don't remember. I think it's on the 25th. So
okay,
just check
we'll
it out.
We'll talk to Willie on that.
Absolutely.
Wonderful. So you're good to go then? That's
good
awesome.
To go.
And Tony, we could check you out. Auntie, we could see him.
Well, maybe. Hopefully it's not. Hopefully it's the camera's on the field and not me.
How do you dial it in? CISN.TV.
Google Central Iowa Sports Network. Just Google Central Iowa Sports Network. That'll get you right there. And as a Cub fan, I can finally say, I understand the rivalry between the Cubs and Cardinals. I understand it's a friendly one. I have many Cardinal friends, but I finally understand why the Cardinal fans are the way they are. And I respect them. When you have great organization, great leadership from the top to the bottom, and the players that play for them together, the Cubs have finally got that. I don't hope anymore as a Cub fan. I really believe the Cubs have a shot. It might not be this year, but it's coming very soon. Mm-hmm. And it's good to see that the Cubs are kind of mirroring what the Cardinals have done for a lot of years. And I'm looking really forward to raising the W again for about eight more times. Win that World Series.
That's the whole game plan. Again, Cubs play tomorrow night against the Mets. The Mets beat the Dodgers last night.
And you got the Jays and the Royals on the other side. How about that? If you'd picked those four teams before the season started, they'd have locked you up.
Who would have thunk it?